Hello students, today we are going to understand the chapter Deep Water, written by William O. Douglas. This chapter is an autobiographical account in which Mr. William Douglas talks about the time when he experienced a misadventure and how that misadventure proved to be something that left a huge and unfading imprint on his mind and soul, the imprint of fear that did not go for many years, but then how he learned how to get out of the fear and be free of it, be courageous enough to live this life to the fullest. Deep Water, written by William Douglas. And what are the learning objectives? Why are we going through the chapter? And what will we learn when the chapter is done? First point, to read and comprehend the text and locate the key points. So after reading the chapter, going through the text, you should be in a position to understand what are the main points and what are the main parts of the chapter and how they are important enough to make you understand the chapter itself. To develop usage and enrichment of vocabulary. To infer meanings of new words from the context. To relate subjectively discussion on fear. This is quite important because the chapter talks about fear and how to overcome it also. Fear is something that we all have. We may have the fear of darkness, fear of height, fear of ghosts, fear of dying. We all are afraid, and any kind of fear only limits us, limits our personality and keeps us entwined in a particular circle out of which we cannot get, and we never try to go out of that circle of ours, the circle of comfort, and learn something new. Then fifth point is to inculcate values like courage and determination. And yes, because we cannot get out of that circle of comfort, what happens? We keep our personalities hidden. We keep our personalities unexplored. And we cannot learn whether we can do this or that, whether we can go for hiking or not, whether we can go for skydiving or not. We never try to learn because we are afraid. But what is more powerful than the fear? It is the courage and determination of a human being that can teach him or her that yes, you can do this. And the last point is to enable the students narrate first person experience. This chapter is an autobiographical account taken straight from the life of Mr. William Douglas. He had written it himself, and that is why we come to know very closely that how big his fear was. What did he experience when he was inside the swimming pool, struggling for his life, every minute of it, every second of it. And when he was completely terror-stricken, how he tried to overcome it, and it was not that easy as it is shown in the movies. It was difficult and it took time. This is the picture of Mr. William Douglas. And he was born in 1890 and he died in the year 1980. He was born in Maine, Minnesota. And he graduated with a Bachelor of Arts and pursued legal career. And he was a legal advisor to the President Franklin D. Roosevelt. The excerpt is taken from his book, Of Men and Mountains, which he has written. And that is how it is an autobiographical account. Moving forward, what do you understand by deep water? What might be the meaning of this chapter, the title? If you have read the text, you will understand that it is about the time when William Douglas was struggling inside the water and how deep it was. Something that is very deep, very dark, it takes you down, down in the darkness. And how important it is to get out of that deep, dark strangulation of water, strangulation of fear. Come out of it alive, free, to live the life. Now the question is, what is this fear, or what is the phobia called? Because if you have a fear of something, there are various terms used to describe that particular kind of fear. So here are some. But before that, let us see what a phobia itself is. A phobia is an outward expression of an internal anxiety. So when a person is suffering from a phobia, a lot is going on inside his body. A lot is going on with his emotions inside. But the expressions come on the face. Through the body, you come to know that the person is feeling something terrible inside. And something within you, but outside your own control. Now, these are the common phobias I was discussing. We have hydrophobia, that is the fear of water. Acrophobia, which is very common, it is the fear of heights. Then we have claustrophobia also, which is the fear of enclosed spaces. Some people are afraid of riding an elevator because they are afraid of the small space there. And then some people are afraid of the open spaces, which is known as agoraphobia. And lastly, we have the thanatophobia, which is the fear of death or dying. People with phobia try to avoid what they are afraid of, because if they can't, they may experience panic and fear, rapid heartbeat, shortness of breath, trembling, and a strong desire to get away. This is very important because they want to just get away from that place because their body is suffering. Why? Because something is going on inside their hearts, inside their body, in their emotions. They cannot express it by saying something because the voice doesn't come out. So what happens? Their body starts shivering and showing such kind of symptoms, which shows that they are suffering from a phobia. Moving forward, what is the theme of the lesson? It is, in this essay, William O. Douglas talks about his fear of water and sense of panic that gripped him, and how he finally overcomes it by his courage, sheer will, and determination. This is the Yakima River, which is a very important part of the chapter, because they lived in that particular area, William Douglas and his family. And his mother always reminded him that how Yakima River was very treacherous, dangerous. And that is how in his heart he had the fear of water there. Well, Yakima River, the picture on the top, the first one, it is in your books also. The Yakima River is a tributary of the Columbia River in eastern Washington, USA. The state is named after the indigenous Yakama people. Now, the gist of the lesson. William O. Douglas had a desire to learn swimming since childhood. And that is how, at the age of 3 or 4, when he went to the sea with his father, he was knocked down and buried by a wave at a beach in California. So that is when he went with his father to the California beach, and the waves came and completely took him over and swept over him. That is when he started having an aversion towards water. He started disliking water. But then later on, he decided to learn how to swim in the YMCA swimming pool. He developed a great aversion to water because of the California incident. Moving forward, the YMCA pool, where he decided to learn how to swim when he was around 9, 10, 11 years old. At the age of 10 or 11, he decided to learn to swim with water wings at the YMCA pool, since it was safe at the shallow end. And then the misadventure happened. While sitting alone and waiting for others to come at the YMCA pool, a big boy came and threw Douglas into deep end of the pool. And can you imagine the situation? The emotions of the boy, a very young boy, suddenly picked up and thrown into the water when he did not know how to learn how to swim in water. Well, that happened with William O. Douglas, and he suffered because of that incident for many years. Douglas swallowed water and went straight down to the bottom of the pool, and that is when his struggle inside the water started. While going down, he planned to make a big jump upwards but came up slowly. And this was his plan actually. Even when he was thrown inside the swimming pool, he was not completely out of his wits. He decided how to save himself, and that is when he planned that when he will go down, he will make a huge jump and come out of water, start paddling, go to the edge of the pool, and that is how he will be saved. But whether that happened to him or not, that is a completely different case. Stark terror seized him and he tried to shout but could not. As he went down the pool second time, he tried to jump upwards, but it was all a waste of energy. Terror held him deeper and deeper. That is why the chapter is titled Deep Water. It was the fear that was deeper and deeper, the fear of water. So he tried to save himself, but every time his efforts were all useless. During third trial, he sucked water instead of air, and that is how he started drowning. Light was going out and there was no panic anymore. When he was drowning, it was also comforting, soothing. He could not feel any more fear. And he was in the clutches of death, and that was peaceful, surprisingly. So he ceased all efforts and he became unconscious. And he crossed to oblivion, the state of forgetfulness, that is death. When revived, he found himself vomiting beside the pool as he was saved by somebody. He was in grip of fear of water and it deprived him the joys of canoeing, boating, swimming and fishing. He states it himself that how he was deprived of all these wonderful activities. And that is when after many years he decided to learn how to swim. Even when he suffered from hydrophobia for many years. But he wanted to get out of it. And what he did, after trying all by himself, when he could not succeed, he decided to take professional help. He hired an instructor. And with the help of the instructor, he decided that he will get out of his fear. He will no more be a hydrophobic person. Sheer determination to learn swimming. He hired an instructor to learn swimming and the instructor taught him swimming piece by piece. He went to different leagues to swim and found tiny vestiges of fear still gripped him. So for around 6 months, the instructor taught him various things, how to inhale, how to exhale, how to paddle inside the water, how to swim properly, all the kind of strokes that are used during swimming. Within 6 months, he was done and then he swam in the swimming pool also. But later on, he actually wanted to go inside the real water body like lakes and rivers. And he went to such places to confirm whether his fear was completely gone or not. And to his rejoice, the fear was indeed gone because of his sheer determination. He challenged the fear and swam off. And the fear was gone, obviously. Swimming up and down the warm lake, he finally overcame his fear of water. The warm lake beside the Gilbert Peak, you have read the text, so you will understand it. He realized that in death there is peace and there is terror only in fear of death. So death itself is peaceful, but surprisingly the fear of death is more panic causing, and that is why we struggle a lot. And because he experienced both, that is why he can say it very confidently here. His will to live is stronger than the fear of death. So when your will power is stronger than death or the fear, you are sure to get over it no matter what. Now the values shown in the chapter which we can learn. To overcome the hurdles that come in our life, we need to have the sheer determination, the courage, the passion to get over it. We can take over, we can conquer over any kind of fear that comes in front of us. टू फाइट अगेंस्ट फियर. दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नो मैटर यू आर अफ्रेड ऑफ अ वेरी स्मॉल थिंग और अ ह्यूज प्रॉब्लम, ट्राई टू बी करेजियस, ट्राई टू ब्रश इट असाइड, फाइट विद इट, फाइट बैक. एंड डिटर्मिनेशन, नेवर लेट गो, गो फॉर इट, ट्राई एज हार्ड एज यू कैन. And to learn how to solve problems. See what William Douglas did? He tried to learn how to swim. But when he failed, he decided to take professional help. At this point, I would like to mention that sometimes we are afraid of things. Sometimes we are stressed out. Sometimes we suffer from depression. If that is going on with you, never shy away from taking professional help. You are not doing it for other people. You are not doing it for the society. You are doing it for yourself. You have to live for yourself. Be a little selfish in your life. Think about yourself. So if you are having some problem, emotional problems, physical problem, social problems, talk with other people. Those who are more experienced than you, those who are experts in these areas, because you have to get out of such problems, fears, phobias, to live a better life, or in a simple manner to say, to live life. Success is never permanent, failure is never final, so always do not stop trying until your goal makes a history. So in second poem, an elementary school classroom in a slum, the last line says, history theirs whose language is the sun. Those people who have a strong willpower, as strong as that of the sun, only they can make history. So if you want to achieve success, if you want to live life to the fullest, if you want to explore the world, explore yourself, you need to get out of the clutches of fear. Then only you can be a free person. And the conclusion is, the author was able to overcome the phobia towards water with his determination to learn swimming, as well as he proved himself as a good swimmer and could enjoy like others by diving. Success comes to those who believe in perseverance, who never give up. So sheer determination, indomitable spirit of fighting back and never giving up, only that can take you to places, only that can make you happy. A happy human being, a happy person. And let's close it now. Do read the text. For understanding this presentation, you need to read the text. This is only a summarized version. Go through the text again and see to it that how the points mentioned in the presentation go along with the chapter itself. Thank you.